Hello friends, welcome back to ProHut IT Services. Good to see you back. In this video, we'll learn about exclusion in DHCP Server 2012 R2. What is exclusion in DHCP? And why do we need to exclude an IP address from the scope? While defining scope in DHCP, it asks for an option to exclude an IP address from scope. We can specify a single IP or range of IP addresses. DHCP Server will not assign IPs that are excluded from the range. Let's take two scenarios to understand it better. In first scenario, let's assume that you have assigned a range of IPs from 192.168.1.100 to 192.168.1.200. This means DHCP will start assigning IPs from 192.168.1.100. DHCP Server assigns IPs on first-come, first-served basis, that is FIFO. Let's assume that first computer will receive an IP address 192.168.1.100. Second computer will receive an IP address of 192.168.1.101. Third will receive an IP address of 192.168.1.102, and so on. In second scenario, let's assume that you have assigned the same range, that is from 192.168.1.100 to 192.168.1.200. In this scenario, we are excluding an IP from 192.168.1.00 to 192.168.1.120. By doing that, our DHCP server will start IPs from 192.168.1.121. That means our first computer will receive an IP address of 192.168.1.121. Second computer will receive an IP address of 192.168.1.122. Third computer will receive an IP address of 192.168.1.123, and so on. DHCP Server will not assign IPs that we have excluded, that is from 192.168.1.100 to 192.168.1.120. Why to exclude IPs? Exclude IP if you don't want DHCP Server to assign the range of IPs to client machine. If you want to reserve these IPs and you want these IPs to be assigned to specific computer, then you can exclude it. We'll talk reservation in detail in next video. If you want to use these IPs in future, maybe you have some other plans to use these IPs. So in that case also, you can exclude these IPs. Or there's a possibility that you want to use these IPs as static IP. So if you want to use these IPs as static IP, but you have defined the same in the scope, in that case, you can exclude these IPs. Hope with this exclusion concept is clear. In the next video, we'll see the practical that how we can apply exclusion and how exclusion will exclude the range of IPs that we don't want to assign to our computers. Thanks for watching this video. If you liked it, then please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Keep smiling and have fun. Bye.